Yo, it's Duff of the Cloud Chaser TV, man. We back up in this thing again, you dig? Hey, man, we got this exclusive content coming to you today, man. Let's get to it, though.
But look, let me ask you this, Runner. What was y'all main thing about how he came at Crip Mac? What y'all didn't like about what he said about Crip Mac, mainly?
Bro, call cuz a buster, cuz. When you did the buster shit, you did that weenie shit, bro. How you gonna call cuz a, like, and then on neighborhood Crip, another issue on your head, nigga. You talk about a nigga got knocked out on Vernon. How the few let cut, nigga? I ain't let nigga 30s to the 100s on the dead homies. I ain't let no nigga beat my homies up, cuz, up in here. As a matter of fact, nigga, can't no nigga 30s to the 100s say that I let a nigga run them in there. Nigga, ain't no nigga running my homies, nigga. And niggas, that's a regular thing, bro, to run. Like, nigga, you got to come in here and catch your face. On 40 Crip, nigga, ain't no nigga, bro, from this roller shit could ever say, baby Runner, let no niggas run his homies, bro. That's, nigga, do you understand the logistics in that, bro? You telling me that 4-5 niggas is gonna get around somebody that you call an ally, bro, right? And then they're gonna take turns fighting this nigga after the third or fourth nigga, after the third nigga, your homie probably, you know what I mean? Like, nigga, gasping or whatever, nigga, he probably, you know, winded or whatever the case may be, bro. I don't give a fuck if you let these niggas, if you make them let cuz take a break, a breather, nigga, and then you let cuz fade, nigga, that's bad enough. But on neighborhood, you gonna let a nigga knock the homie out. This by your own words. So you saying that cuz got knocked out by your words, bro. So if he got knocked out, boom, right? You let cuz get up and squabble another nigga and then get knocked out again. And then get up and squabble, like, bro, that's bust, bro. That's some buster shit, cuz. And homies do it, and niggas is busters, cuz. Niggas do that shit, nigga. I don't give a fuck, nigga. On the dead homies, niggas not even, man, nigga. 30s to the 100s, nigga. On God, niggas do the homework, nigga. I'm not never letting that happen, bro.
Let me ask you this, though, Runner. What you think about Brick Baby initially lying about that, though? Because from my understanding, he went on no jumper and made it seem like Crip Mac was actually winning them fights and knocking niggas out and shit.
Straight out hood. Beat up Nutty Boy and trying to evil on neighborhood Crip, right?
That's what I'm saying, bro. Like, you can't listen to a motherfucker that's sitting, and that's where niggas is like, you know, niggas is looking at that like, what? Like, bro, what? See, because if he would have said that originally, we would have got on him about that. You feel me? He had to say that. Because that's what I'm showing y'all. That's the hood way to, like, that's hood. You feel me? We don't consider, like, that's spoke. Okay, cuz with it here, he squabbled up. The way he told that story, that's acceptable. You feel me? The homie here knocking niggas out. So it was like, all right, whatever. Nigga, like, I'll let cuz keep squabbling. That's the only thing that make it spody. Because if cuz would have said that off the muscle, niggas would have ate his ass up then. You let the homie just get out, cuz, like, and get beat up? Like, nigga can't hit my homie too hard, cuz. I be ready to, nigga, what? Nigga on hood. Like, bro, oh, watch out, cuz. Cuz, all right, cuz done, bro. On FY. that shit gonna get looked at, bro. You gonna have to stand on LA, bro. That shit, it be the flukiest shit. It be the most flukiest situation that, you know, on the real, bro, like, that'll catch you. Nigga, you think you good. You and Chuck E. Cheese, nigga. Nigga, it's five of these niggas up in there, nigga. Like, the fuck are y'all doing in here? You know what I mean? Like, you know, nah. At the end of the day, bro, just stand on. That's the only thing I ask of a nigga, man. Just stand on business, you know, when it come to you. It's gonna come. You know what I'm saying? You just gotta stand on business when it come, bro. You know what I mean? And then it's hard for me to kind of have a problem with you if you standing on it. Like, shit, Brick Baby, you could have just came outside. I would have respected that, bro. I ain't gonna lie. I'm a real one, bro. I would have respected that, bro. To even just come outside, bro. You ain't have to let them niggas in. You could have just came outside. I'm not sitting in the house for nobody, bro. Come to my house, I'm coming outside, bro. I just don't see that, bro. Like, that's like, you know, that's, and then it's your homies. I will feel so disrespected. Like, nigga, y'all niggas, what? Some allies pulled up on me. Like, I'm coming outside, bro. We gonna have a conversation or however it gotta go. I don't know, man. Like I say, but on the internet, that might not be, you know, because people defend that. Like, you know, on the internet, that's not really an offense, bro. But, you know, if you stick it to the code, bro, that's crazy. Dead homies.
So, how do you think this situation with him is gonna play out, or is this something you probably shouldn't say on the internet?
I mean, you know, like I said, I'm a dress cut when I'm definitely a dress cut when I see, you know what I mean? Cause you know, I'm from neighborhood, so your DP got something to do with the rest of them, but you know, your interaction with me, nigga, we definitely need to, you know what I'm saying, need to go ahead and get what we gotta get, you know what I'm saying, or whatever, nigga. Upon us seeing each other and shit like that, bro. Like, you feel me? You know, unless it's some special circumstances or something that happened in between that, my nigga. Like, but nigga on crib, like, that shit just, you know, I just don't feel that. And as you being a homie, cuz I be feeling like we obligated to address you, my nigga, like, on God. You feel me? Like, that's not a cool look. And then you still not looking at it like, that's the shit that's really lingering, is that you still not looking at it like you fucked up. Like, bro, you fucked up, my nigga. That's weird, bro. You still explaining it and shit. Like, nigga, fuck is you explaining for, nigga? Like, there ain't shit to explain, nigga. And like I said, we ain't the home, nigga. I didn't talk to homies from everywhere, nigga. From 9-0, from Hunnids, nigga. You know what I'm saying, nigga? Dead homies, nigga. The 50 homies, like, niggas ain't feeling that shit. That shit weird, bro. Then you got it, Mac, like that, like, nigga, that's butt, like, I don't know, how y'all feel about that? How you feel about, cuz, like, letting that slide and then getting on Mac, like?
The example that he used when he was coming to Crip Mac, right? I don't know if a lot of y'all know who Neon is, but it's this, like, little nerdy streamer that he made it seem like, yo, I'm the only one that checked Neon when, you know, he was disrespecting Crip Mac. Like, bro, nobody took that situation serious, whether you in the streets or not.
You just let Neon blow up everything you stand for. Dead homies, I'm the only reason that Neon even felt any type of pressure about saying what he said about you.
And I don't know if you got a chance to hear it, but when he was even coming to Crip Mac, bro, he doubled down on that point. That he's like, yo, even if DW were to say it, because that's his homie, like, he made it seem like it's something that would just stay between him, but...
This nigga blows it up. Mind you, it's a whisper, and I wasn't going to act no other way. So when I tell that part of the story, I'm not saying it to say, oh, if I did hear it another type of way, this is my homeboy. Actually, let's not say nothing else to shine no light on it, because I'm trying to just sweep it under the rug and get through it, because I know my homie.
Seems like it's bigger than that. That's kind of what I'm learning, is like, from you and, you know, some of the other members and shit too, talking, like, it's not something we can really sweep under the rug.
Yeah, nah, like, the fact that, like I told him, bro, The fact that you saying sweep under the rug is some Mark shit, bro. Like, that's considered some Mark shit for us, bro. To say this nigga dissed your hood and you was trying to sweep under the rug. You can't say that to no... That's not going to sound right to no gang member, bro. On 4-0, nigga. That ain't going to sound right to no gang. What the fuck? That right there, that stop everything. You was going to sweep. Cut this in your hood under the rug. To eat. Like, the sound of that sound, Mickey, bro. Like, you know, like, nigga, so... You know, that's just, like I say, man, a nigga, another nigga that made his own bid, bro. You made yourself the target for this type of shit because you online portraying that you know what I'm saying, you sold by the code and you sold by the book, my nigga. You feel me? And that shit ain't by the code and that shit ain't by the book, bro. Ain't nobody letting that shit go down like that out here, bro.
Shed is live on Facebook and Twitter with a hashtag. Let them know what's going on. Salute to the people, man.